Hello, in this WAGO tutorial, we show how to commission an MBUS meter and read values in a simple application. Here we have a PFC200 to which the 753R649 MBUS Master module is connected. A power meter is connected to the MBUS terminal blocks. For commissioning, we first launch the WAGO I/O check tool, establish communication with the controller, and read out the Fieldbus node via Identify. If we select the MBUS module and click on Settings, we receive a friendly note that we need the MBUS connector plugin. This is available via the website wago.com. So we search for MBUS connector at wago.com, download the plugin, unpack it, and first install the MBUS connector. The MBSheet tool, which is also downloaded, is installed via the MBUS connector installation dialog. We start the installation dialog, confirm that the device software is to be installed, leave the checkmark so that MBSheet is installed. We do not need the desktop icons, as we usually open MBSheet via I/O check. If we now select the MBUS module in the I/O check and click on Settings, as before, MBSheet opens. There are two ways to search for meters, one via the primary address and one via the device ID. Since we have not assigned any primary addresses yet, it is likely that the meter connected to the MBUS still has the primary address assigned by the manufacturer, usually address 0 or 1. Therefore, we start the search for the device IDs here since they are unique. The connected meter is displayed. As the primary address is not queried in the ID search, a 0 is always displayed here. Now we can assign primary addresses in the range from 0 to 254, for example, the 3. And with a right click, we set primary address via ID to link the new primary address to the device ID. When searching for primary addresses, we now also see the assigned address, so we can identify any multiple assignments. Alternatively, you can read the MBUS, which we will show later. For later use in CodeSys, it is important to know that the device ID is a hexadecimal number, which is often not spontaneously recognizable, like it is in this example. This completes the commissioning of the meter, and we begin with a first simple application. The goal is to read out the energy value of the electricity meter and provide the value in a variable in the format kilowatt hours. So we create a standard CodeSys 3.5 project, search for our controller, and scan the KBUS. In the library manager, we add the WAGO MBUS app. We create a new program and call it up in the main task. For MBUS applications, a priority between 6 and 14 that is not in the background and an interval time between 30 and 80 milliseconds are recommended. We now go into the MBUS program and create a new box in the first network. To fill this with life, we open the input assistant with a double click, search for the MBUS master module, check the insert with namespace prefix box and confirm with OK. We assign a unique function block name, confirm with enter, and the MBUS master is declared. The inputs and outputs of the master must now be assigned. Double-clicking on the iPort opens the input wizard and we search for the MBUS module 753649 in the I/O config globals area and confirm with enter. This connects the master module to the hardware MBUS module. The iPort is our communication to the MBUS. The master module now makes all values that pass via the MBUS available for use in the application on the B port. Since there can be multiple MBUS masters, we have to assign an address for the B port. In this case, we start with address 1. To read out the status string, we assign the variable SFBMBUSMaster0Status to the output SStatus and declare it in the autodeclare. This makes the master module ready for operation and we add another network. Here too, we first add an empty box and define it in the input assistant as a timer module from the standard library with the function ton. With the function block ton, we generate a start variable that flashes regularly in order to trigger the mbus query cyclically. We assign the name oton0. At the in-input of the module, we need an AND gate, which we can insert by right-clicking on the input and insert empty box, for example. We only need the AND gate. One input of the AND gate is the output of the ton module, which is oton0.q. And this must still be negated so that the time is re-triggered whenever the module falls back to false. We assign the variable x start 0 to the second input of the AND gate, have it declared and also negate this input. We assign exactly this variable x start 0 to output q, but we have to define it as set by right clicking directly in front of the variable. Now we give pt a time, in this example only of 5 seconds, to be able to show the function of the module. In practice, significantly longer times are common here, for example 15 minutes. In this example, we do not need the output et, which is the elapsed time. This completes the ton function block and we add a new network. Here we add the module FB mbus electricity from the Wego mbus library, which we use to read out the connected electricity meter. On the B port, we enter address 1, so this module receives the mbus data provided by the master on the B port address 1. For DW address, we could enter the primary address of the meter assigned in MB sheet, but we'll make it a little more elegant here using a variable that we initialize with the assigned primary address 3. Send NKE is set to true so that the mbus device receives a command to initialize each time it is read out. On xstart, we set the variable xstart0, which is set to true by the timer function block ton as soon as it's false after 5 seconds. When the query is completed, the electricity module resets xstart0 to false and the ton module resets it to true after 5 seconds. Therefore, it flashes. The values of the meter are now made available at the outputs of the module and we assign unique variables to each output. We do not need the xupdate output here. This value is true if a valid telegram was successfully received. This allows us to read out all values that the function block electricity provides. If we log in now and read out the values, we see that the values are still somewhat strange to represent and still have to be converted. To do this, we log out again and add a new network. We are now creating a new box and we can find the function block FB unit converter auxiliary tools in the WagoApp mbus. This is sufficient for most applications and the long real version of the converter is only required for very high counter values, for example in the megawatt or gigawatt range. For example, we create the type energy 0 variable at type mbus record output. For input eUnit, we assign a new variable with the name eUnit energy and initializes it with the unit kilowatt hours in the auto declaration via the 3 points in the column init value. The converged value is now at the R value output and we assign a variable here. X error is not required in this case. This network is ready, we log in, start the controller and see the energy value in kilowatt hours in the R value energy variable. With the function block FB mbus electricity, we can read out the total meter values for energy, power, voltage, and current. In most cases, however, a meter provides significantly more data. These can be read with the function block FB mbus multitel. So, new network, new box, and we add the function block FB mbus multitel from the Wago mbus library and declare it. Accordingly, we create the addresses and declare variables for xstart and the outputs, sstatus and type mbus info, as before. The new xstart variable also arrives at the AND gate and the output of the timer module. At the ambus record output, the entire dataset is now provided to us as an array, and we assign and declare the variable AM bus record multitel 1 for this. We also assign a variable to the B number of records output, which indicates how many values we can read out overall. When we log in and start the controller, at B number of records, we see that 32 values are available to us. If we open an array tree, we can see what is transferred in the array, and we could conclude from the unit WH that this is probably an energy value. We find a better representation in the MB sheet, so we stop the controller, log out, open it via IO check, and search for our meter. We then read the MBUS via the Read MBUS button, and all the values of the meter are displayed, including the descriptions. To use multiple values in the codesys, we note the corresponding array numbers. For example, total energy number 1, voltage on phase 1, number 14, and current of phase 1, number 17. Back in codesys, we create a new network in which we call up the function block FB unit converter. This should convert the total energy, so we enter the array from the multitel module at the record input and simply enter the previously noted array position in square brackets. We have already created the variable for the energy unit and assign it to the eUnit input. Now we only need one variable for the output value, and we can read out the energy in the correct unit, but now via the multitel function. In order to read out the other values, for example, those we cannot read with the electricity module, we create two new networks with copy and paste, including the unit converter, and change the names and array positions. 14 for the voltage in phase 1 and 17 for the current in phase 1. In each case, a corresponding variable for the unit and output is also created. And we can test the application. The three values are displayed to us, and if we now switch a load on L1, the current in L1 also increases. This application could be expanded as it is for multiple meters by creating additional multitel modules with xstart variables. Here we did that for 40 meters, which is the maximum possible number of meters on a WAGO MBUS module. Here is the AND link of the start variables to the TON function block, and here is the list of all multitel modules. When we start the program now, we see how the TON module sets all xstart variables to true after the time has elapsed, and how the master module processes one query after another, and the respective xstart variable is set back to false by the corresponding multitel module. Basically, this application works. However, the limits of the FBD programming language have been reached here. As you can easily imagine, troubleshooting can become a time-consuming challenge, for example. In addition, we have only added the multitel modules here and no converter yet. Implementation in the ST programming language would have been significantly faster and would have been more elegant and clear.